The main purpose of these chapter videos is to motivate the chapters in your life. Keep in mind that your life is a general term. For example, I might show you the need for a statistic in putting cola in cans. While you may never personally work in the plant that puts cola in cans, you benefit from their correct work. Each chapter has a theme. In chapter one, we are looking at the coronavirus. In addition to showing you the real life value of chapter one, in unit one, I also want you to see that you know most of this material already, but you are lacking the vocabulary in chapter one. The idea is that while you understand all of these concepts, your goal in chapter one is to learn the terminology. So listen to these examples of things that might happen concerning the coronavirus. You ask COVID-19 patients how they feel on a scale of 1 to 10. You determine if COVID-19 patients have no symptoms, some symptoms but well enough to stay at home, are in the hospital without a ventilator, or in a hospital with a ventilator. You want to try a new medication on COVID-19 patients and compare to current treatment, both the death rates and the time until the patient is released. Last year, we could have tried to determine how the virus would spread by observing the number of infected people every day. First, each of these four statements should sound like something you understand that you know why we care about. But each of these four statements also has two things that you should be able to classify: a type of study and a type of data. At the end of the chapter, I will reveal the answers to those things. Each of these requires that you collect data from COVID-19 patients. Let's stick to COVID-19 hospital patients in North Carolina. There are many ways to collect that data. Six examples are given below. Select every COVID-19 hospital patient in North Carolina. Select the third room of COVID-19 patients. Select all COVID-19 patients in one hospital in every county. Select five COVID-19 patients in every hospital in North Carolina. Randomly select 1,000 COVID-19 patients from across the state. Select the first 1,000 COVID-19 patients in North Carolina that you can find. Each of these uses a different sampling method that you should be able to identify by the end of chapter one. Again, the answers will be available when we finish the chapter.